Hello students, welcome to APG Pathshala. I am Dr. Seema Khanna from Hans Raj Mahila Mahavidyalaya, Guru Nanak Dev University, Amritsar. Today we are going to talk on module Human Values in Jainism from paper Human Values and Indian Ethos. After studying the entire text, students will be able to understand to know about the religion of Jainism, to understand basic human values and teachings of Jainism, to inculcate basic human values of Jainism in our youth. Introduction. Jain Dharma is an old Indian religion. The basic idea of Jainism is non-violence and respect for all the living beings. Jain word has been evolved from Sanskrit word jina, which means conquer. A jina, as per Sanskrit language, is a person who is away from all inner passions like wants, desires, attachment, greed, anger, pride, etc. The followers of the path of jina are known as Jains. The drivers of the Jain path are known as Tirthankaras. History of the Jain teachers is concluded with Mahavira, consisting of 24 teachers. The basic prayer of Jains is Namokar Mantra, which means we should always help each other. The main two sub-traditions of this religion are Digambras and Swetambras. These both traditions have different practices. Maximum Jains reside in India. Some of the big Jain communities are present in other countries like Canada, Europe, Kenya, and the United States. Main festivals of the Jains are Paryushana, Dasalakshana, Mahavir Jayanti, and Diwali. Principles and practices of Jainism. Jainism is a source of core human values which have been explained as Ahimsa, that is non-violence, as a main dharma. The fundamental values of this religion constitute Ahimsa, which means non-injury or non-violence. This is a basic commitment of every Jain. Killing or harming anyone physically or by the words of mouth, both are strictly abandoned by Jains. All the living organisms must help each other. The cause of violence is anger and hate. Violence destroys our soul and mind. This conduct of non-violence helps in spiritual development, which also affects one's salvation and release from rebirth. Ahimsa may cause bad karma, consequently future sufferings. Anikentvada, many-sided reality. The truth and the reality can be experienced, but with language or speech, we are not able to express or communicate them completely. Only through good actions and deeds these can be experienced. The Jain religion teaches us to accept all the positive and negative facts of life. There is no God or creator, but only one thing is permanent, that is Jiva or soul. From ancient times, it goes parallel with other religion, that is Buddhism and Hinduism. But sometimes it's very critical for the knowledge system and ideologies of other religions. Aparigraha, non-attachment. It concentrates on non-possession from worldly things or property. Followers of the religion must be satisfied with only hard-earned limited money. Moreover, they must donate any surplus money. Non-attachment may be of two types, material and psychic. Material possessions are relating to property and wealth. Psychic relates to emotions and feeling. Attachments may result in the direct harm to individual personality. Jain monk or nun is supposed to be homeless and familyless, away from any belongingness. As per them, internal attachments are anger, ego, greed, and deceitfulness. They also suggest that we can overcome anger by forgiveness, and pride by humility, and deceitfulness may be conquered by straightforwardness, and greed by contentment or satisfaction. Other internal passions are like dislike, fear, sorrow, laughter, etc. Ascetism. Jainism follows strongest ascetism. Such life means nakedness or non-possession of even clothes, keeping fast, body mortification, etc. To be free from old karma and a restraint on new karma. This is most required for getting siddha and moksha, that is salvation or liberalization from rebirth. Ascetic austerities constitute 6 outer and 6 inner practices. Commonly outer austerities include complete fasting, limited eating, only to eat few items, and avoid tasty food and avoid flesh. It means to avoid temptation of everything. Inner austerities include compassion. Inner austerities include confession, respecting, assisting mendicants, study meditation, and detachment from any wants. Ultimate aim is to purify our souls. Mahavira has set an example of a good ascetic life by adopting severe austerities for 12 years. Asteya, that is non-stealing. A Jain mendicant should always take necessary permissions to get anything from others. They should accept only those things which are given to them voluntarily by others. They are strictly opposed to theft and stealing. Brahmacharya, it means celibacy or away from sex and sensual pleasures for Jain monks and nuns. But for lay persons or followers, Brahmacharya means complete faith with our life partner. Food and fasting. Most of the Jain follow lacto-vegetarianism. It means they don't take even eggs. Root vegetables like potatoes, garlic, onions are not eaten by monks and nuns. The plants are also considered as living things. They believe that when plants are pulled, they are injured. During festivals, Jains fast, which is called upvasa or tapasya. Jain lay persons eats only twice a day, drinks boiled water, or sometimes complete fasting during festivals. Fasting practice is done to improve their karmas or actions. Fasting is very common in Jain women. They observe fast for religious purity, family goodwill, and future well-being of her family. Dhyana, meditation. It is a most essential practice in this religion. As per different views, meditation is a form of austerity and ascetic practice. It means one has to be pure. One must leave selfness rather to concentrate on enhancing knowledge. Jains believe that they must be on the right road to meditate on the soul, the pure self. They also focus on the periods or the timings for meditation. Some of the Jains believe to meditate thrice in a day, especially mendicants. Some lay persons practice rituals as puja in a Jain temple and charity work. Rituals and worship. Jains have faith in darsana or watching of Deva, including Padmavati, Ambika, and Brahmadeva. Digambras have a sub-tradition called Therapanthi. They do not worship many of the deities. Dev puja ritual is very common in all Jain sub-traditions. This is practiced by Jain doing namaskara to God in the temples. One of their practices include Abhisheka, that is ceremonial bath. These rituals are matched with the Hindu rituals. They also recite mantras. Most famous eternal mantra of Jainism is 5 homage, that is Panka Namaskara. Monasticism. Jainism has furthered Digambara monks and Swetambara monks. Digambara monks and nuns carry with them the feathers of peacock and always sweep while sitting or walking in order to avoid small insects being crushed. Shvetambara monks also follow the same type of practice. Four old order of Jainism consist of Muni, that is male aesthetics, Arika, female aesthetic, Srivaka, layman, and Sravika, lay women. Jiva, that is soul. As per Jain philosophy, body means matter and soul is consciousness. Soul or Jiva is different from other substances, that is matter, time, space, dharma and adharma. Other substances are called a Jiva. As per their ideology, all living beings are soul, immortal and perfect. Soul is embodied in our body just like in a prison. Tattva, that is reality. Tattvas are the ways to obtain moksha or salvation. This is the ultimate solution for attainment of the goal of liberalization. There are seven tattvas. Jiva or the soul. Ajiva, that is non-living things like matter, time, space, etc. Asrava, that is influx, means entry of evil matters in the soul. Bonda, that is bondage. Samvara, stoppage, that is to stop the evil matters in the soul. Nirjara, that is gradual dissociation. Moksha, that is liberation. Soul and karma. Natural soul is a mixture of impurities like natural gold. Soul is closely associated with karma. For the refinement of soul, the Jain karmic theory important to explain pains, sufferings and inequalities. Realization of this reality is a supreme destination of Jainism. Samsara, that is cycle of rebirths. Jainism strongly believe in samsara. As per their thoughts, soul passes through 84 lakh birth situations. They believe that soul passes through five types of bodies, that is earth bodies, water bodies, fire bodies, air bodies, and vegetable lives. Soul changes the bodies again and again. Therefore, we should concentrate on karmas. Tirthankaras or God. As per Jainism, there is no existence of God. As per external universe, Jain cosmology, the whole cycle of the world has been divided into two parts, that is Avsarpini and Utsarpini. As per their thoughts, 24 Tirthankaras are present to bless the whole universe in every half cycle of time. Mahavir Jain is regarded as the last Tirthankara of Avsarpini. Tirthankaras are the role models for Jains to show the path of liberation. Salvation, that is liberation. As per Jainism ideology, three jewels can show to the way of salvation. They are right view, right knowledge and right conduct. There is one more jewel which is also considered by them very significant, that is right aestheticism. Only following all these four practices, moksha can be obtained. These four jewel practice under this religion is called moksha marg. Morality and virtues. Jainism related to the interconnection between religion and morality. One must live a good life as well as go higher to divine perfection. There are different ethical standards and values for laymen and monks. To avoid pain and loss in living beings, practice of dharma is most essential. 10 virtues of Jainism are humility, purity, non-attachment, self-restraint, superforbearance, straightforwardness, truthfulness, and complete renunciation. Thoughts, actions, and speech are governed by these virtues. Dharma and morality are related to each other. Morality and virtues. Jainism related to the interconnection between religion and morality. One must live a good life as well go higher to divine perfection. There are different ethical standards and values for laymen and monks. To avoid pain and loss in living beings, practice of dharma is most essential. 10 virtues of Jainism are humility, purity, non-attachment, self-restraint, superforbearance, straightforwardness, truthfulness, and complete renunciation. Thoughts, actions, and speech are governed by these virtues. Dharma and morality are interrelated to each other. Equality in men and women. A book on Jain system of education clearly states that Jains laid stress on educating all the individuals, kings, princes, princesses, and even laymen. Their main aim was to provide knowledge and wisdom to all men and women to build their character by practicing some discipline in their student life. Then they could become good human beings and will facilitate nation building. As per their philosophy, women should obtain respect and honor from their fathers, brothers, husbands, and even brother-in-law. Women respect means pleasing God. Education in Jainism. They consider education as very integral and intrinsic in their life. Knowledge acquisition is not education. Education means knowledge, vision, and building a good sound character. Education is a way to achieve the major aims of life. Education is a way to achieve the major aims of our life, that is liberation. Jainism way of life is to educate on our own to get quality soul, which will lead us to perfection and liberation from all worldly sorrows. Jain schools. Two major subgroups of this community are Digambara and Shvetambaras. Both have different dress codes. Their individual thoughts are also vary from each other. Monks of the Digambara sub-community never wear clothes, but female monastic of this tradition wrap white sari, which is unstitched and plain. These are called as arikas. Shvetambara monastic usually wear white seamless clothes. Digambara and Shvetambara are further divided into subgroups with their own beliefs. As per Jainism, liberation can be achieved by males mostly. Women can get salvation only by improving their karmic merit to take birth as men. Women can get salvation only by improving their karmic merit to take birth as men. Jain symbols. The main Jain symbols are swastika, which means important Jain symbol. It constitutes four states of existence. Devas, that is heavenly being, human being, hellish being, Triyancha, that is subhumans like flora or fauna. These symbolizes the existence of beings in different states. Ahimsa symbol. In this symbol, there is a wheel. Inside it, there is a hand. In the middle, Ahimsa word is written. Wheel signifies Dharma Chakra. It means non-violence is the ultimate religion of Jains. Jain emblem. Jain emblem represents heaven, hell, and material world, that is three lokas. Beyond these three realms, on the upper side, a part signifies Siddhashila, a zone beyond the three zones. On the emblem, three dots symbolizes Ratnatriya, right thinking, right knowledge, and right conduct. Symbol of Ahimsa is present on lower portion and swastika is shown on top area. At the bottom, their main mantra is given, which means all life is bound together by mutual support and interdependence. Jain flag. Jain flag consists five colors, that is white, red, yellow, green, and black. White color shows that souls who are free from anger, attachments, and all passions. Souls who have obtained self-realization. It also denotes peace and non-violence. Red depicts Siddha as a soul with truth and liberation. Yellow signifies the Acharya, the masters of adepts, and Acharya, non-stealing. Green color shows Brahmacharya and Upadhyaya who teach scriptures to monks. Black symbolizes Jain aesthetic, which means non-possession. Om. It represents Namokar Mantra. It is a short form of five Parameshthis, that is Arihant, Ashri, Acharya, Upadhyaya and Muni. These are the Jain gurus teaching Jains. These are the souls who are free from all passions. Mahavira and his teachings. One of the oldest religions called Jainism was established by Mahavira Vardhamana. He presented the philosophy of Jainism in different way, but he was not actually the founder of this religion. He was born in 599 BC. He belongs to a very wealthy family, but he spent his life with great hardships doing meditation and fasting. He was related to 23rd Tirthankara of this religion. He showed the way to live happy and peaceful life. Right knowledge, right faith and right conduct are the ways to shape the life of an individual as per Mahavira. All the living beings, that is human beings, animals and plants, have pure souls full of knowledge. He strongly believed in karma and also guided us to free from the miseries of karma to acquire moksha or nirvana. He had no faith on God, but he had a faith in the powers of all the souls. Mahavira stressed upon five principles, which are ahimsa or non-violence, satya or truth, astya or no stealing, tyag means no property, brahmacharya or virtuous life. As per Mahavira, moksha can be obtained by karma theory. His teaching has a good impact on all the Indians, religions, culture and languages. It has also worldwide impact on countries like USA, UK, Canada and East Africa. He did not believe in caste, creed, rich and poor, moreover any gender discrimination. He suggested us to be truthful and honest. He said that in every living being there is a spirit, so he laid stress on vegetarianism and to avoid injury to animals. His ideology was equality, self-control, spiritual liberation and non-violence. His life had a great impact on community. He advocated about universal brotherhood of man and human rights. He visualized of a democratic society. He stressed on the egalitarian society on the basis of non-violence to obtain a state of equilibrium, social peace and excellence. Jainism had unqualified faith in human rights. Summary. As per Jain philosophy, violence is a sin which is against the dignity of human being. Human dignity means human rights. We must have maitri or friendship with every living being. We should respect for mankind and all other living beings. We should do charity for needy people, which is called karuna. Highest wisdom is to do generous service to mankind, that is madhyasthya. Guiding force of non-violence is compassion, that is daya, which is the basis of religion. Jain believes in rational consciousness, samyaktiva. In our old Vedic values, compassion is a must. Such type of atmosphere will basically promote and protect the rights of men. Non-violence is means as well as end towards creation of a society. Mahatma Gandhi, a great political leader, was also following the path of non-violence in the struggle for independence of India from the British rules. Gandhiji also had a good impact of Mahavira's teachings. The Jains also claim that compassion for all living beings is possible after self-realization and spiritual wisdom. An important maxim of Jains are first knowledge than compassion. The theory of their religion also depicts to live and let live. In today's era, when word is going very fast, the basic ethical and moral values have been deteriorated. It is essential for the educational institutes to provide guidance and training to the future of India, that is, our young students. Some of the part of religious teaching must be imparted to the students to follow the preaching of our old religions. This is most essential to produce good human beings. This is also a way to stop violence, which has become a prominent feature today. The word peace and harmony can be obtained only by inculcating moral and ethical values in present and upcoming generations. The cause of the destruction of our society is that we have forgotten the basic rules, principles, and value system of our old epics and religions. There is a great contribution of Jain religion to our society. But the present Western culture has provided us a life full of comforts and luxuries. Such life is an obstacle in front of humanity. India, a country of Vedas, Upanishads, Vedic culture and religions, is today facing a very chronic phase. Modernization and westernization is trying to dominate our community. The ultimate solution is to practice our old religious values and customs. Thank you.